Hello all. In this session, we have to continue. We are continuing with module 4, that is global environmental concerns. Today's topic would be like the ozone depletion. Ozone layer is in a kind of an umbrella of 24 kilometer, that is of 15 miles from Earth's surface, an essential component of the stratosphere that absorbs short wavelength ultraviolet radiation from the sun, heating the gases of the stratosphere in the process. And this is the reason like temperature raise with increasing altitude in the stratosphere, and also the reason of able to move out of the ocean and onto the land, like evolving into the diverse biosphere like which we know today is in today. And ozone depletion, like gradually thinning of Earth's ozone layer, which is upper atmosphere, like causes by the release of chemical compounds and containing gaseous chlorine or bromine from industry and other human activities. And the thinning is most pronounced in the maybe in the polar regions. And the World's Ozone Day is celebrated on September 16th, and this question can be expected in both IA and exams of every year. And stratospheric ozone is measured in DU, that is Dapson units, named after G.M.B. Dapson, who pioneered the study. And one Dapson unit would be like 0.01 mm thickness of stratospheric ozone, and the average ozone thickness in stratosphere is 300 DU, and when it falls below 200 DU, it considered as an ozone hole. So maybe this is also an expected question, like when the DU, that is Dapson units, which is falls below 200, maybe it is considered as an ozone hole. And it is the thinnest around equator and thickest near the poles. And what are the causes of the the ozone depletion? The ozone depletion is caused by the releasing of CFCs, that is chlorofluorocarbons, and other ozone depleting substances, which were used widely as a refrigerants, insulating foams and solvents. And here the ozone depletion gradually thinning of the Earth's ozone layer in the upper atmosphere, caused by the release of chemical compounds containing gaseous the chlorine or bromine from the industry, and also the Earth's surface, which is increased the rate of after the this ozone layer directly, which is a UV rays are directly which is transferring to Earth's surface, like maybe there is risk of skin cancers, eye cataracts, and genetic and the immune system damages would be happen. And ozone level has dropped by a worldwide average of about 4% since the last 1970s, and this is consequently unabsorbed and dangerous ultraviolet radiation, which is able to reach the Earth's surface at the higher intensity. What would be the effects of the this ozone hole or ozone layer? The effect of ozone hole includes cataract, genetic mutation, constriction of blood vessels, reduced crop yield, leukemia, breast cancer, damage on crops, aquaculture, etc. And the higher energy UV radiation absorbed by ozone is generally accepted to be contributory factor of skin care. To the skin care. And also in addition to this, like the increased surface UV leads to increased tropospheric ozone, which is a health risk of humans, and the increased surface UV also represent an increase in the vitamin D synthetic capacity of the sunlight. And also, what would be the control measures for this? And in 1987, like the Montreal Protocol was signed, and the signatory nation committed themselves to a reduction in the use of CFCs, and that is chlorofluorocarbons, and other ozone depleting substances since that time. The treaty has been amended to ban the CFC production after 1995 in the developed countries, and later in developing, like today, 160 countries have been treated. And also, we can't make enough ozone to replace what's been destroyed, but provided that we can stop producing ozone depleting substances that which harms the natural ozone production, reaction should remain the ozone layer to normal level by the about 2050. This is an expected thing. And what will be the effects, this defect, ozone depletion effects, that is, like, it's caused increased in UV radiations levels at the Earth's surface, and when it is damaging to human health, like negative effects include increase in certain types of skin cancers, eye cataracts, and immunodeficiency disorders. And also, UV rays also affect plant growth and reducing the agricultural productivity. And this human activities cause the emission of halogen source gases, like that contain like chlorine and bromine, which atoms, and these emissions into atmosphere ultimately lead to stratospheric ozone depletion. And the source gases that initially only carbon, chlorine, and fluorine is called chlorofluorocarbon, that is usually abbreviated as we used to call CFCs. And to avoid the consumption of gases, like dangerous gases, which is affected to ozone layer, due to this, like content or manufacturing process can be done. And minimizing the use of cars, and do not use cleaning products that are harmful to the environment and to us. And also, we should not buy the local the products which is concerned to the, the climate change or greenhouse effects like that. And also, what is the importance of this ozone layer? If we are living without, if you want to live without ozone layer, like, what will be the disadvantages from that? Like, life could not exist without the protection of the ozone. So, which is also called as a ozone layer. Without the ozone layer, like, we could not live. And the sun gives off light, heat, and other types of radiation. Like, too much ultraviolet radiation can cause skin cancer, cataracts, and harm plants and animals. So how it will be, the forming? Like, ozone is a molecule made up of three oxygen atoms, which is often registered as O3. Ozone is formed when heat and the sunlight, which causes chemical reactions between oxides of nitrogen, and also the violet organic compounds, which is compounds, nitrogen and violet organic compounds, which also known as the hydrocarbons. Thank you.